The following video was requested by Lofty the Rapper Offline Guy 2000.
Episode 30. Eliza meets William Kahlon and Aluna Mwangi.
So, you must be Eliza, right?
Yes. And you must be Lofty the Rapper Offline Guy 2000 and Sienna.
Yes. I'm Lofty's female clone.
Huh? That's the first time I've ever met a Go animator with a female clone.
Well, I'm not the only one. There's also Carson Animate, whose female clone's name is Carla. And Dennis Animate's 2K9 aka Cajon Pass fan Gemstone 2K9, whose female clone's name is Abby.
Okay. So, I heard that two of your OC characters want to meet me.
Yes. And they should be here right about now. These two are my OC characters, William Kahlon and Aluna Mwangi.
Mwangi?
I'm of Kenyan nationality.
You know, some of my friends are black, but I've never actually met someone of African ethnicity before. But it's nice to meet you and William. My name's Eliza.
It's nice to meet you too. By the way, Lofty told us that you got abused by your biological parents. And Aluna and I can totally sympathize with you because I know what it's like to have an abusive relative.
You too? You mean that you have abusive parents as well?
No, neither Aluna nor I have abusive parents. But I actually have a racist and homophobic older brother.
A racist and homophobic sibling? What did he ever do that's considered racist and homophobic?
Over a decade ago, my brother Oliver and his girlfriend Amber co-founded a gang of troublemakers called the International Terrors. They are a group of troublemakers created with a misguided goal to bring normality to the city where Aluna and I come from.
Unfortunately, they do so with acts of racism and homophobia against not only people of my color, race, and ethnicity, but people of Asian color, race, and ethnicity as well. And even members of the LGBTQ community. Until the beginning of 2024, William and I were members of that gang.
What? You two were part of a gang of racist and homophobic criminals?
We didn't join them willingly. Oliver and Amber forced me to stay compliant with the International Terrors and manipulated Aluna to turn her back on her own kind to join them. They even threatened to slit me in the throat if I ever told anyone about exactly what the International Terrors were capable of. Me. Oliver's own brother. So when I found out that Oliver and Amber brought knives to school to kill two Japanese girls, I began to feel remorse for everything I did as part of the International Terrors.
So on New Year's Day of 2024, William and I made a resolution to redeem ourselves by cutting ties with the International Terrors and apologizing to everyone we've done wrong.
But when Oliver and Amber were scolded by our parents for what they did to force us to be part of the International Terrors, the two of them took us to a cabin to torture us.
And if my brother Ganti hadn't tracked my cell phone and if he and the rest of the Kahlons hadn't called the police on Oliver and Amber, William and I would have been dead.
Lofty, Sienna, Crow Girl 22, and Crow Tune Productions Incorporated, am I hearing all of this correctly? Did this Oliver and Amber actually do all those horrible things?
Yes, they did. And I gave them the worst card of all during my latest behavior card day because of that.
I saw the whole thing. Oliver and Amber have become dangerous psychopaths. And because of them kidnapping and torturing William and Aluna, their fathers plan to disown them.
Yeah, racism towards all people of color is one thing, but homophobia towards members of the LGBTQ community is no better. These international terrors are both of those things.
William, you have the sickest, most psychotic, and sorriest excuse of a brother I've ever heard of. How could you and Aluna have been associated with that monster?
I didn't know what I was getting into back then. William had no choice back then. He was forced to keep his brother's gang's racism and homophobia a secret from me and his family.
Well, what Oliver and Amber did to you was way worse than how my biological parents treated me. Torturing the two of you with dangerous weapons is the worst thing they've ever done. Those two are even worse than Mr. Adams.
Huh? Who's Mr. Adams?
He's the most racist and abusive teacher that was ever introduced in Angel Rapper 1003's channel. He was racist towards all black people, including my friends Richmonda, Ronald, and Bruno. He was also overly strict and gave all the students he taught very difficult assignments.
And he even brutally assaulted Eliza in front of her classmates when he was substituting for Mr. Bloom and called me a puny little alien.
That racist beast has been so discriminatory towards all black people, including my girlfriend. She's been super angry with him ever since. Black people have been the biggest victims of racism for years. Even more so than Indians, Hispanic and Latinos, and Asians.
You gotta be kidding me. Aside from getting abused by her parents, Eliza and her friends have also been abused by an overly strict and racist teacher.
That guy's almost as bad as my brother. Just out of curiosity though, because you said the way Oliver and Amber treated me and Aluna was way worse than how your parents treated you, what exactly did they ever do to you?
My parents abused me the exact same way they did my half-siblings. My biological dad, Boris, grounded me for dumb reasons like he did Caillou, Rosie, Cody, Daisy, Emily, Lily, Sapphire, Hannah, Agnes, and Amanda, such as being a pick eater, and like my biological mom, Deanna, did to Eric, Stephanie, Natalie, Terrence, Elizabeth, and Joseph, she did much worse. For example, when I turned 4 years old, my mom woke me up with an air horn at 5:30 in the morning like she did to Natalie almost half a decade ago, and like she did to all my half-siblings from her side of the family while placing them under spanking probation. I was given a hard-boiled egg while my parents had French toast.
Spanking probation?
What the heck is a spanking probation?
It's a dystopian household rule where Deanna spanks whichever of her kids disagrees with her, disobeys her, and or does something bad and grounds Diesel Gavin for the first
thing. In other words, she grounded the Diesel Gavin for disagreeing with her when she first placed all six of their kids under spanking probation.
Exactly. And when I refused to eat the egg, my mom threatened to spank me. But then she spanked me for calling her crazy. And then when I called the police on her and my dad, she threatened to not only spank me again, but to give me a concussion, ground me forever, and give me a brutal punishment day.
But our creator's version of your dad never did that sort of stuff. He only gave Caillou and Cody a consequential and low-key punishment day for pranking their sisters and mom.
What do you mean consequential and low-key?
It means that the very punishment day video I ever made doesn't involve any signs of physical violence whatsoever. Caillou and Cody only had to clean the house and backyard, eat the food and watch the movie they don't like, and land on something soft while getting pushed off the roof.
How exactly did Caillou and Cody prank their sisters and mom?
During science class, Cody created an enhancement potion to alter a girl's lips. He tested it on Gina and Gab first before he and Caillou put their prank into action.
Ew. Gross. I don't think I would want big lips. I would look super ugly. Then again, as long as the punishment day wasn't brutal, Cody and Caillou definitely deserved it for pranking their sisters, Doris, and Rosie. Anyway, William and Aluna, it was nice to meet you too, as well as Lofty the rapper Offline Guy 2000 and Sienna.
You too, Eliza. By the way, you're cute and a really tough fighter, even as the leader of the Dogs of War.
Aw, thanks, Aluna.
When William and Aluna returned home.
So William, how'd it go with you and Aluna meeting Eliza?
It went well. Eliza's actually a cute little girl. Unfortunately, we found out that Eliza was a victim of child abuse and has friends who were also victims of racism.
What? Eliza was a victim of child abuse? Are you serious?
And she has friends who are also victims of racism?
Yes. Someone named Mr. Adams brutally assaulted Eliza in front of her class, called Richmond Cooper, Ronald West, and Bruno Lopez aliens, and gave them very difficult assignments.
What? You gotta be kidding me. This Mr. Adams really did that?
Yes, he did.
Unbelievable. That guy's almost as racist as your ex-brother. Not to mention misogynistic.
Yeah. And to abuse students like that. That guy's so sick in the head. It's a good thing he didn't use any weapons to kill the black students like Oliver and Amber tried to do with those Asian girls at your school.
Yeah. That's what I said to Eliza when she told us.
What? Eliza was a victim of child abuse? And Boris Anderson's her biological dad and married to that psycho Karantiana?
Yes. All that's true. Crotoon Productions Incorporated's version of Boris is not as reasonable as our creator's version of him.
And Eliza has friends who are also victims of racism because they had an abusive substitute teacher who beat her up in front of the entire class and called them brats and aliens.
Yes. And while two of them were black and one of them was Puerto Rican, Mr. Adams assigned seats out of discrimination against students of all color.
What a sick monster. He's almost as bad as Oliver and Amber. It's a good thing Mr. Adams didn't use weapons on people of color like they tried to do to you and those Asian girls.
That's for sure. The fight against racism has always been a struggle. But if combined with that against homophobia, you get a gigantic cluster of destruction.
And now we've reached the end of today's episode of Life with Eliza. And if you like this video, be sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe. This is Crowtune Productions Incorporated.
And this is Crow Girl 22.
And this is Lofty the Rapper Offline Guy 2000.
And this is Sienna, signing off.